The Tupelo Furniture Market had been open for only a few hours, and Clifton Spencer had already placed several orders.
Plants like we're looking at now, little small items.
The Germantown, Tennessee businessman is one of thousands of out-of-town visitors to the fall market. Overall, the furniture industry has been hit hard by the sluggish economy in recent years, but buyers are optimistic. Jimmy Hopper was placing orders for his son's business, the Pineapple Shop in Blue Springs. He says through lean times come valuable lessons.
If you don't give good service, you're not going to have customers. That's one thing we try to do is go the extra mile, so to speak, you know, giving people and try to have what people want, too.
Arkansas-based Jenkins Lamps makes it a point to help store owners as much as possible to boost their business.
Well, we tend to give bargains. We tend to give discounts and just keep people free freight and just things of that nature that will help stimulate their sales. And when that stimulates their sales, it stimulates our sales.
Business was brisk at Verona-based Capital Bedding.
We've actually been really busy. We just now put all kinds of new stuff out on the market, and everybody's trying them out, wanting to look at them and try them.
Buyers can find more than just furniture at this market. Nettleton businessman John Hall has an item he feels will be a big hit in the furniture industry.
The bed bug buster is, bed bugs are beginning to be a big factor, especially in some other states. It's an all natural product, both human friendly and pet friendly, and it does not require an exterminator to spray.
Most of the vendors, buyers, exhibitors, and sellers are repeat visitors to this market. They say the combination of hospitality, bargains, and loyal customers keeps them coming back even in lean economic times. In Tupelo, I'm Allie Martin, WCBI News.